heart tips. Okay, now we're to the heart. Oh, we're not quite to Northern Exposure yet, because I think that's the, what people loved. But we'll talk about sobriety first, because that happened before Northern Exposure. What I learned in sobriety are coping skills. Coping skills. I didn't have any coping skills when I was young before I got into the 12-step program. I didn't really know how to cope with fear, anxiety, joy, anything without having been a celebratory event with a glass of wine or champagne or something of that nature. So, you know, when I got sober, I had a lot of black holes and had to learn how to cope. And that's one of the things I've learned. And I just love to share these things that I've learned because we all have stress, right? I know that, you know, very few in the room have any issues that they're dealing with alcohol, but we all have stress. And stress can certainly have an impact on the heart. I know that because when I get stressed, my heart will try to go out of rhythm and I'm very, very conscious of my own body. But halt. Don't get too hungry, angry, lonely, and tired. Have y'all heard that? Halt. Halt. Like stop. And I've learned before I do anything, whether it's if I'm feeling stressed and I have a big phone call or a business thing I have to do, I think, am I hungry? Maybe I should eat a little something before I make this phone call. And I will make sure I eat and am hydrated before I get into a stressful situation with a phone call or anything in business. Angry. Anger and resentments. Resentments will eat away our souls and eat away our bodies in the process because resentments just bring in so much anger. So one of the things I learned was to deal with resentments was to write them out, to call that person, to clean up my side of the street. You know, I can't control how the other person feels or how the other person reacts, but I can control what I do. And so I've learned that when I'm wrong, promptly admit it, or if I have a resentment, deal with it. And that resentment probably involves, I was probably a part of that story with that resentment. So I call that person, get together with that person. I actually talk through it and clean up my side of the street and let go of theirs because I can't control theirs. And there's something so healing about that. I've learned that the stress in the body and what it can do to our hearts and in our everything, arteries, veins, strokes, the stress, for me, a lot of it is when I have resentments and it just grows and grows in my head and I've got to get rid of it. I have to deal with it right now. And by the way, lonely and tired, getting lonely, back to halt, don't get too hungry, angry, lonely and tired. Well, angry is the resentments part. You know, I think resentments breed anger. Lonely, you know, whenever I find that I get isolated or lonely, which sometimes I'm out the ranch by myself, you know, that's really not a good place to be because, you know, I don't know, you can think too much. And tired, got to get some sleep. Boy, I don't know about you, but I love 7 hours sleep. I rarely get it. But if I get 3, 4, 5 hours, I really can't cope very well. And that happens a lot when you're a mom, right? But letting go of resentments, clean up my side, one day at a time. A lot of times I say 1 minute at a time, 1 minute at a time. Sometimes through the dark holes I've been through in my life, I will just say, this moment is what I can get through. 1 moment at a time. Ego, my ego. When I start thinking about myself too much, easing God out. Ego is easing God out. I want to be in control of my own life, and that creates this ego that gets really difficult. Fear. I have a lot of fear. I don't know if y'all have fear. I have fear and anxiety. Fear, false evidence appearing real. So I say to myself, this is fear. Now, how much of this is real? Is it false evidence appearing real? Really important to me. And I've learned not to judge others because judging others, you know, I've realized who am I to compare my life with someone else's life? I don't know their heart. I don't know where they've been in their life. And C.S. Lewis has a great commentary on this in Mere Christianity. I don't know what they've been through. And to God, something that they're doing, but yet they'll do this one little kindness, may be a bigger deal to God than to me. To what I'm doing, maybe I'm expected to do more than that person. God only knows people's hearts, so who am I? Who am I to try to deal with that heart? So when I take judgment away, resentments, halt, all these things, ego, it really helps me to get my life together, make gratitude my attitude. I always think that. You know, when I was on Northern Exposure, there was a lot of grouching going on because we would work sometimes 18 hours a day. Grouching, is that a word? 18 hours, long, long hours. And I just remember saying, before this, I was broken and unemployed. I had $8 left before I booked Northern Exposure. I was at wit's end, very, very depressed. A lot of times people just complain and say, you know what? I'm just so grateful. They say, you know, how do you feel working these long hours? And how do you feel? I said, well, it's better than being broken unemployed. you know. So I'm making gratitude my attitude is really important to me, and forgiveness as well.